Hey everyone, how's it going? My name's Mayuko, and welcome back to my channel where we talk about tech, career, and life. Today, we're gonna be talking about imposter syndrome. I've actually already talked about imposter syndrome as part of a course that I did on YouTube about a year ago, but I wanted to make like a standalone video because this is such a universal topic. And my video quality is so much better even just in a year, and I feel like I talk better on the camera. So today we're gonna cover what is imposter syndrome and how does it relate to technology and software engineering. And I just wanna share my advice, just like from one human being to another, from me to you as a software engineer. Yeah. And before we get started, I want to say thank you to Trends for sponsoring today's video. Trends is the ultimate knowledge hub from The Hustle. When you subscribe to Trends, you get access to so many different leaders in many emerging fields, especially in tech. You can workshop ideas and network with CEOs, entrepreneurs, and investors through Trends. It's been really cool to be on the Trends platform because there's a ton of articles about emerging markets and trends and analysis about all the different things that are happening in the business world, which all of that is inextricably tied to tech. And while you can read a lot about these things in other news sources, a lot of this discussion is happening on Trends. They've got a ton of great research on different markets and an incredible community to connect with. So right now you can get your first 2 weeks for just $1 by going to trends.co/Mayuko for your $1 2-week trial. Thank you again to Trends for sponsoring, and now back to the video. So yeah, let's first just level the playing ground and talk about what imposter syndrome is. A lot of y'all might know this already, but I think of it as like you severely doubting your own abilities and accomplishments. It's all those feelings of just like, I don't deserve this. There's no way that I could have gotten it. I'm not really good at what I do. What if I fail and everybody knows that I'm just not actually very good at what I do? All of those kinds of thoughts are imposter syndrome. I'm not gonna dive into like more the definition or the medical terms and psychiatric terms and stuff, but I will leave resources in the description box down below for you to learn more. But hopefully you're at least familiar with the feeling of imposter syndrome. Maybe you've had it, maybe you've heard of your friend having it, maybe you've seen it out in the wild, you've read about it. It's a very common phenomenon. And while common, it's very, very uncomfortable. This is just my interpretation, but I've seen this graph about describing your rings of comfort zones. The middle ring or center being your comfort zone, the place where you feel safe and secure, and each ring or zone outside of that is kind of a layer further from that place of safety. And so in an ideal situation, you start from the very center, your place of comfort, and you slowly inch your way out and you start to discover what else is out in the world. And then your actual ring of comfort becomes bigger and bigger and bigger because it swallows all the other rings as you're inching outwards towards the world. I hope this analogy is making sense, by the way. But I think imposter syndrome happens when you're in your comfort zone, but you're kind of just like picked up and placed in a ring that's not adjacent to the inner circle. So you're basically in a place where you're just like, I don't know how I got here. I don't know where I am, and I'm clearly very far away from home. Like you're literally just getting dumped there. And that's the state that I think describes why you feel like you're a fraud, because you don't see the path that you took from the inner circle to the outside. It feels like someone just picked you up and put you there, even if it was your own doing and you actually traveled the distance. Maybe you don't believe that you got there on your own, or maybe you don't trust the path, or maybe you just feel like there must have been other things in the world that has just like picked me up and dumped me here. Whatever the case, you just feel like you're lost and that you're an imposter. That's kind of my own interpretation of it. I noticed that I get imposter syndrome in those specific situations. Maybe it happens in other ways for everyone else. But yeah, imposter syndrome is a really, really common phenomenon in the tech industry. In surveys in and around the industry, it shows that the majority of people have experienced imposter syndrome. Every event that I've talked at where I ask people to raise their hands, like, hey, have you experienced imposter syndrome? Most people raise their hands. Which is funny because I think every time someone finds out that other people are feeling this, it's a surprise to them. So yeah, part of this video is to like make you feel less alone because like, trust me, I've had so much imposter syndrome, and I will talk about my own personal experiences in a bit, but just know that it happens really freaking often in tech. And I think a lot of people in tech experience this at different stages of their career in different situations because they don't really know how to prepare for them. And it's not because they're not skilled or they're not supposed to be there. I just think it is really hard to prepare for a job in tech sometimes. Because take software engineering, for example, it takes a lot of skills. You have to master a lot of different things in order to be a great software engineer. Like you need to master the art of coding and different technologies and programming languages and frameworks. You also need to understand how a given code base is architected and how all of those things come together. Software engineers also need to deliver all of that out into the wild as a high quality product and make sure that everybody gets a good experience. And that honestly doesn't cover half of it because engineers also need to understand how the business is run and how the product works. And in order to do that and code with other people, you have to work collaboratively with coworkers and different kinds of roles, which requires skill in both written communication and verbal communication. And if there's issues, you need to figure out how to debug them effectively without freezing up like I do sometimes. I mean, software engineering, in a gist, is about solving problems you've never solved before. And I think it's the truth that a lot of college programs and bootcamp programs don't necessarily prepare you completely for what's to come either. Don't get me wrong though, some people just know what to do from the get-go and certain programs are really effective at preparing their folks for the industry. But I'd venture to say that even those people experience imposter syndrome too. Because even if you did know what to prepare for, every single job and role and company and product and person that you work with are so different from each other. That like, in a lot of ways, there's just like no way to prepare for it because you just kind of like gotta do it and get in there, get your hands dirty and just start learning. I mean, personally, every single time I've started anything new, I've felt some massive imposter syndrome. Whether that be like starting a new job at a new company or being put on a new project or being told to work on something where I'm just like, I literally have no idea how to do this. Heck, sometimes I'm the cause of my own imposter syndrome because I put myself in situations and I'm just like, I don't know what I'm doing. And sometimes it does get so bad where I'm just like, you know what? I'm good. I'm gonna quit because I'm not fit for this. Like, y'all hiring me or putting me on this project was like a grave mistake. And I'm just gonna make it easier for you because I cannot do this. Luckily, that's never actually been seen to fruition because when I tell people that I feel that way, they're just like, well, you go. Everything's okay. You're fine. Anyway, I just want to share my own experiences because I will say that imposter syndrome can definitely be managed because for me, it's gotten way more manageable over the course of my career. And so this is where I share some of my advice. My first piece of advice is kind of like something that I always remind myself when I'm feeling imposter syndrome, and it's that everyone has their own beginning. And I tell myself that because when I'm feeling impostery, I look around at other people and I'm like, they just know exactly what they're doing and they've known how to do this forever and I will never get to that level. But hey, nobody is ever born with the abilities that they have because they all started from somewhere. Everyone had a day one of X, day one of coding, day one of walking, day one of eating, day one of being a manager, and everybody started from somewhere. And likely everyone was probably pretty bad at it from the get-go. Like, I know I was pretty bad at walking at the beginning. But you make slow and steady progress, and then you gain those skills over time. Like, you know, when you first started to code, you likely wrote your first Hello World program, and that's where it all started. You didn't even know how to run the program or what to type, but you started. And then from there, you just built on top of those skills. And so knowing that everybody has a beginning reassures me that whatever level or state that I want to get to can be doable with some slow and steady progress. The second piece of advice that I have for managing your imposter syndrome is to check in with someone. One of the really hard things about imposter syndrome is that it's really easy to get in your head and be overly critical about yourself because no one is stopping you from doing so. And it's really hard to be objective about yourself. Like, everyone's their harshest critic, and so you end up kind of like beating yourself up and talking yourself down all the way down. And so one thing that I think is really helpful is to talk to a friend or a manager or a trusted colleague who understands your work or your accomplishments to listen to your worries. Because first of all, verbalizing your fears makes them real, which I know that in and of itself is scary, but at least you're facing it. And if there's one thing I've learned from experiencing crippling anxiety sometimes is that you do have to face your fears. Because if you keep ignoring it and you just think that it doesn't exist or something, then it doesn't actually address the fear at all. And once you tell that to someone, then likely your friend, trusted colleague, manager, whoever, is gonna hype you up and support you so hard. Or even just by like verbalizing it to like a wall, you'll realize how critical you are of yourself. Like think about if you heard a dear friend or family member be super critical of themselves. You would stop them, right? And be like, yo, like what the heck are you talking about? Like that's totally not true. I've seen you do X, Y, and Z. Like you're gonna do this. You're great. You're totally fine. Or whatever you would say to your friend. I don't know, that's what I would say, but maybe you'd use some different words. And all this kind of leads into like my last piece of advice is to, yeah, figure out what you're afraid of and then make a plan. Usually when I'm experiencing imposter syndrome, it's just that everything is entirely overwhelming and I can't even see the details of what I'm afraid of. And sometimes I know exactly what I'm afraid of and what I'm feeling impostery about, but it's really important to, I think, address that first. Because once you identify it, you can address it. Like for instance, maybe you do a little bit of introspection and you realize that one of the sources of your imposter syndrome is that you feel like you don't know a technology as well as other people on your team. So, sample plan, maybe you get a sense of their actual skill level first. And you can do this by just like asking them like, hey, how did you get to your skill level? In which case they might point out some of the resources that they used or explain like a project that they worked on or something that really upped their level. And then you talk to your manager and say something like, hey, I want to get really good at this technology and I feel like I'm not there yet. I've been giving resources and types of projects that I can work on and I was wondering if you could help me. And then you can build a plan with your manager. Like not only are you coming up with a plan, but now you have a partner in that plan to both hold you accountable and support you and give you these opportunities. Another example, which I've definitely experienced, is that you're afraid that you're gonna get fired at your job because you feel like you don't belong. So, sample plan, you talk to your manager about this fear. You say things like, I am so afraid of getting fired because I feel like I'm not performing well enough and I feel like I'm not at the right caliber as everybody else. And hopefully they reassure you. They can talk about a plan of here are the things that you're doing well and here are the things you're not doing well and here are the things we can work on together to address all of these things. And now every time you bring that up with your manager, like, hey, I'm not feeling particularly hot right now because I feel like I'm still not performing that well, your manager can remind you, hey, it's okay, we've got a plan, you're doing great, you're not gonna get fired. I think this is all just kind of related to like when there's a mountain in front of you that you have to climb, instead of focusing on how scary and big the mountain is, just take it one step at a time, put one foot in front of the other, and next thing you know, you're either gonna have climbed the mountain or have made a good amount of progress towards the top. So yeah, anytime things are scary and big and looming, just take it small, like make small bite-sized chunks that are a lot more manageable, and then all of a sudden it becomes a lot less scary. So yeah, that's my advice for imposter syndrome. If you have any pieces of advice or your experiences with imposter syndrome, then leave them in the comments down below. And if you like this kind of video, then consider subscribing. I make other videos that are related to tech careers and software engineering and sometimes lifestyle things, and so come join. That's it for today, but I just wanna say you're not an imposter. Be kind to yourself and don't judge yourself so harshly. You have freaking got this and I believe in you. I'll see you next time. Bye.